Hello, America. London calling.
They didn't want me to wear this, you know. They suggested something gothic with tassels, but I just looked like a cushion from Cher's bedroom. And the idea of wearing nothing but a whistle and a clipboard filming in October in London didn't appeal either. Maybe the lady Susie Chameleone spoke to could design something more alternative.
So today I've managed to pin down the ever-busy Janine Gibbons of Wicked Leicester Clothing. Today we're here with the beautiful Joanna Strange, makeup artist extraordinaire. Hello, John.
Hi.
The success that you've had in a relatively short amount of time. Why do you think this is? Why have you been so successful?
I've put it all down to social media, to be honest. It's basically what everyone has to use nowadays if they want to get well known. I still don't see myself as well known, but it's, yeah. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, you've got to be on everything and you've got to keep updated, but it works out.
The project that you've worked on so far, what's been your favourite?
I've worked on lots because I work in all different genres, but I'm definitely going to have to say this is probably my favourite.
Yeah.
Very recently I was finished up working on the Adam's Family musical
in
Birmingham, and I was lucky enough to be helping with artists as well, so I had a team below me. It was stressful, it was hard work, but it was so amazing. Got really good friends with all the cast and crew, and that's one of the best things about theatre.
Yeah. So you've just launched an Etsy shop just a month ago. Tell us a bit about that.
It was about a year ago I started making headdresses and accessories for shoots, just to bring something extra to have, you know, an extra thing to add to my skill set. There's so much competition in the industry. It's better if you sort of have something else to bring to the table.
Mm.
So I started making them, and I've been doing it ever since, really.
So thinking about the future, dream projects that you'd love to work on, or people that you'd love to collaborate with, is there any in mind?
There is definitely, there's loads, but top two that I always think about is working with like one of my favourite music people, you know, on tour or on a music video, so Marilyn Manson or Alice Cooper, someone very theatrical, very horror orientated. And then I'm a massive fan of the Hostel and the Saw films, and so working with James Wan and Eli Roth, basically, even as a makeup assistant, would just be phenomenal, because the stuff that goes on in their brains is just, I would love to just sit and
pick, and
to work with them would be amazing.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Let's finish on any mishaps, funny stories, disasters on set that you can share.
Because I work on a lot of photo shoots, there's always weird and wonderful things happening, you know, models wearing very high heels, falling over, that sort of thing. But I think the best thing was when, well, the worst for me, was when I was working at an event last year, and one of the models I was talking to and asked what she did, if she had a, you know, a job outside, a normal job. And she said a beautician, but I misheard her and thought she said magician. So I started going on about how amazing it would be if I could collaborate with her, how I've always loved magicians and like watched those Houdini stuff. You know, all this stuff. I've really been fascinated by it for, you know, since I was a child. And I gave her this big long, you know, talk.
Oh,
and
no.
She was like, didn't say magician, I don't know what you're on about. And I was like, okay,
oh, the ground's awkward.
Yeah.
Ground's follow me now.
She was really cool about it, but yeah, it was a bit awkward.
Well, thank you so much,
thank
Joanna,
you.
For your time, and yeah, it's been a pleasure to get to know a bit more about your work, and all the best for the future.
That's it for this week. Back to you in the studio, Xander.